This video, what do you see? Great. Is it a man holding a microphone? I want you to pay attention, huh? This is also part of listening comprehension for a while.
I'm so excited to be united again with our favorite singer, Andrea Bocelli.
What is
He's
his name? What is
very
his name?
sensitive.
Anyone
Now,
can
of
tell me?
course,
Can type, can
Andrea and
type.
I
No
grew
need
up
to say,
in
type.
completely different parts of the world. My Christmas in Canada was filled with,
Christmas in where? Christmas in
Victorian
where?
traditions. But I want to know a little bit about your Christmases, Andre, when you were a child. What were they
When he
like?
was a what?
I think it was not so different to your Christmas. A beautiful
A
Christmas
what?
tree.
A what? Come on. Type your
With my
answer.
family together,
Can you hear what you
singing
say
new
now?
songs. Well,
Can you
the
hear
one
now?
universal thing is that
Emily, can
Christmas
you?
is really, for sure,
Emily?
a special
Yeah.
time for
Yeah.
kids. And Andrea, I think you have a special song, right?
What song? What did he
Yes.
say? A what song?
For the kids. Check this out. You're going to love
Ready?
it. I'll say no more. You better watch out. You better not cry. Better not call. 'Cause I'm telling you why. Santa Claus is coming to town.
Okay. Do you wait? Okay, can you tell me? I'm not sure you heard of Andrea Bocelli. Have you seen him sing before? Anyone? No. First time? First time? Right. How do you find his voice? Correct. Yes, please. Today you need to talk to me. This is the last lesson here, and this is a recording because I might be forced to delete because of copyright issues. Chanken, so I'm so sorry. If they have to. So, what do you think? Which country is he from? Any idea?
USA.
USA. Thank you. Talk to me, huh? Today is the oral. You need to talk to me. Nigeria. Which country?
America.
America. Now, please don't Google. Don't cheat. Emily, do you think he's blind?
No.
Oh, just because he closed his eyes, I also can say, "Is this anyway watching? You
I'm
better
like
not why."
really feeling into the mood, so he's just closing his eyes.
He's blind.
Oh.
He's blind. He's blind, if I'm not mistaken, when he was very young. Okay, he's an Italian singer. Italian singer. So this is the first time you hear an Italian gentleman who sings. Usually Italian guys are very handsome, very boyish look. He's blind and he's an opera singer, you know, the high-pitched singer. Okay, a lot of Italian singers are all this very high-pitched. Why I show you this is he's from Italy and he speaks very well English. The guys who play piano is actually, if I'm not wrong, is from British. So this is just to give you an idea that Andrea Bocelli is one of my favorite singers. Every year, Christmas, without fail, I will listen to his song. Trust me, I mean, this will be a Christmas mood. If you can Google it, type Andrea Bocelli's Christmas song. A lot of nice, beautiful song. Some of the song he sang is in Italian. Okay, now this is one of them. I might need to pause, but I'm not sure whether I would love to let you watch this because this is also another way of listening comprehension, the presentation skills. There's an impromptu. I need to pause, continue. Okay, just look at this one here. Okay, I want you, this is a very famous series in US when I was in my early 20s. One of the actors here just recently passed away, and my two adult children love to watch these. And if you really want to improve your confidence level, the jokes they tell, the English, the title is called Friends, Just Friends. Just Friends, seriously. And their songs is very popular now, okay? Just watch for less than 3 minutes, okay? Halfway, I will pause and ask you questions, huh?
I think he's still out. What's wrong? Well, I'll tell you, Rachel Karen Green. I have plans with Joey tonight, and he left me this note. Steve can't make it. Got a date. Talk to you later. Big Daddy. Big Daddy. Oh, that's the nickname we were trying out.
Hey, you know what nickname never caught on? The Rossitron.
This guy.
He's just a princess.
This guy just passed away. He was on, I would not say much. I don't really know, but I just heard that he was on drugs and he just recently passed away at home. Right?
What are you middle naming me for? Hey, Monica, why are we watching the Business Channel?
Because I was going by it the other day and I saw that there was a stock with my initials, MEG, on it. And sometimes I have to watch for 2 or 3 hours before it comes up again, but when it does, it's pretty exciting.
Please look at the way they speak, the mouth, the jaw, the yao zi, okay, please take note,
Okay, honey,
Wait,
you
Blake, can you turn on your camera, please, if you can, thank you.
really need a job. Hey, I went up. What? My stock, MEG, it went up 2 points. Did you realize that if I had invested my $127 in myself yesterday, that
What is the middle name? For example, Blake, your surname is what? What is your surname? Nissing
Go.
Zhou.
Yeah.
Blake Zhou, right? Okay.
Yeah.
For example, if you have become a Catholic, like me, my name is, you see there's a center, there's an R there. It's Raymond Ralph Shaw. The Ralph is my middle name, not my middle finger. Okay, my middle name, Ralph. So the Ralph is actually a baptized name. So in Americans, some of them got middle name. Like Joe Biden, I think Donald Trump also got a middle name inside there. Okay, that's what they call middle name. Take note. So Greg, maybe your surname is what? What is your surname, Greg?
Ciao.
Sound right. So Greg, maybe Greg Stephen Chow. So Stephen might be your middle name. So Blake, Tom, so okay, get it? Right, Nigel say, right? So Nigel, Philip say. So the Philip is your middle name. Why? Why people got middle name? That because some of them use the middle name because they are baptized Christian. Okay, just to let you know,
Yeah, a lot more than that today. I'm gonna do it.
Do what?
Put all my money in me. about, you don't know the first thing about the stock market.
What's the no? Buy, sell, high, low, bears, bulls. Yes, Manhattan.
Yeah, tell the number of the stock selling store.
What happened to MEG?
He's supposed to go to the stock market and ask to buy some share, but he called Manhattan because Manhattan is one of the stock markets in US. And end up, the Manhattan store is actually selling what? Sheng Siong, cold storage, wrong stock market.
But I dumped her. You know, my motto is get out before they go down.
That is so not my motto.
Your middle name is Pamela?
Yes.
No, I never knew mine. Do you remember what it is?
Yes.
Phoebe.
That's my first name.
Right, okay. Then no.
Hey, Bob. Hey, Toby. Have a good night. You like that? Just call you Toby?
Yeah, he thinks that's my name.
Well, why don't you correct him?
Oh, it's been going on way too long now. You know, I mean, the first time he said it, we were just passing each other in the hallway, so I didn't say anything. And then the next time he said, hey, Toby, you want a donut? I wanted a donut.
And, he had a joke because he doesn't know his name, so he just wanted a donut, just accept the name Toby.
5 years later, the donut's gone, and I'm still Toby.
James Chandler, you have to tell him.
No, that would be so awkward. Look, besides, we work in different departments. He's on the sixth floor, you know, so...
You see the way he pronounced the word department. Department. The rhythm. American, the way they pronounce in the British is different, eh?
What's the big deal? Could be worse. Oh, he's calling me Muriel.
Muriel. Why would he call you Muriel? Oh my God. Chandler M. Bing. It's not just an M. Your middle name is Muriel.
Okay, you have to get the American jokes, sir. Don't mind. All right, just to give you the idea, sometimes you have to watch this kind of sitcom or not just a drama or even the songs. Like if I don't tell you it's from Italy, do you know it's from Italy? Of course, you can go and check it out. Chandler? Not this guy, Zach. Hey, you know them,
It's not.
It's not here?
It's this guy that, like, no, like, there's not on the Chandler.
I really can't hear you. So if you want to watch this, it's called Friends, right? Seriously, if you really want to improve your English, this is one way. But some of the jokes, you might not get it, because some of them is the American jokes. So you have to get used. But it's good to get. I don't really watch them, sorry. But just to share with you. Okay, thank you. Yeah, one of them, I can't remember. I think it's just, sorry, that's why I'm not very good there. But I just bring up the Friends because I feel that it's easy to understand. It's fun. This sitcom, so-called season drama, has been for a while. Okay. So later, I'm not sure I'm going to delete this now. Matthew Perry. Okay. You watch Friends, Zachary? Do you watch them?
No.
Then how you know them? How do you know them?
I just do it.
Okay. Come, ready? You watch, Who is watching?
No, my parents watch it.
Your parents, Then you should join them, my dear.
I got no time.
I really can't hear your mic. So sorry, my dear. I really can't hear. Okay. You have to move closer. I will ask each and every one later on. Okay. I think don't share this one first. Stop sharing. Let's go to the notes that we have today. So today is the last lesson. Thank you so much for the past six lessons. Those of you who have not taken your paper 2 exam, most likely will be on Christmas Day, face-to-face, okay, at the Grassroots Club. So those of you who have my contact number, please contact me, all right, the three of you. I think you know who you are. Fred, Zixian, and Changgen, right, the three of you. Hey, my Christmas Day, no? Taking exam with you guys, so please, hopefully you can come. I'm still tentatively putting on 25. Okay, approximate durations of paper 4 is 20 minutes per candidate, including 10 minutes of preparation time. This paper consists of two parts which may be thematically linked. So this is something new to you because it's a new format. Part one is to plan the response. Candidates plan and deliver a response of up to 2 minutes to a video clip and accompany prompt presenter on a computer screen. Candidates are assessed on their ability to present their ideas and opinions fluently and effectively to engage the listener. So one way of thinking is to watch those sitcoms or dramas on the YouTube, like Friends, it's free. Okay, and you can see how the way they talk, they respond, quite pretty good. Now, this is one of them, Friends. There are other movies and sitcoms and dramas to watch. Okay, that's the best I can think of. Of course, if you want to watch Mind Your Language, there's a British, very funny sitcoms, comedies. You can learn from them if you want to. The main thing is to listen to how they talk. Okay, and practice your listening comprehension skill, of course. Right, so plan. So how are you going to plan this? Always bring out your nine friends. Why, where, what, who. Later we'll go through the video. That video also my first time watching it. I watched through just the quick one. So my advice is from now on till all the way to your exam, please watch some movie videos or English movie videos or some like just now the guy who's singing to get the ideas. How do you find the kids? I think some of the kids there are Italians, may not able to speak very well fluent English. So you can say it was a very vibrant, very beautiful scene and bring out the mood of Christmas. At the same time, the background playing pianos that, and also a big audience watching, it looks like really a season Christmas mood. And I used to have this experience last year, even though it was being locked down in Singapore, but I do have a good warm bondings with my family members, okay? So this is very true, especially this one, part four. I take it very, very, very serious. Don't joke with me later, huh? I'm serious. Okay. Few days ago, I was doing this oral and readings. One of the students nearly cried. I would say cry means really tears. That boy is a PSLE boy. When I talk, okay, guys, I'll do like that. Emily, can I see your face? All of you, please show me your full face. Whether you like it or not, today is the last lesson. So what happened to Emily, one of these students said, hey, hello. Excuse me, would you mind pronounce the word properly? Next year, you're P6, okay? And sit straight, two hands on the table. Don't shake your leg. Do I make myself clear to you now? Wow, you cannot take it. Because the past few months of lesson are very nice to him. But next year is PSL, you all know, right? No joke, right? You need to present yourself. Hey, please. That is the reason why, Greg, I understand. I prefer face to face. I want to see how you sit. How you talk to me, how you present yourself. Because I also want to share with you the tips of how to present yourself, because at this part of this this moment of your life, you're going to go for DSA or interview or whatever it is, to go for IP school or some good JC you might have interview. You need to present yourself. I used to be an interviewer and interviewee. And now I still interview people for staff who join my boss company. Right? So this is very important. Later I'll share with you. So be serious. Don't joke. Especially if I say I can't hear you, please move your mouth closer. So that's why, Greg, I prefer face to face. But because of time, people are still flying. I don't want them to miss any of the lesson. I hope you understand. Shi Xian and Chang Ken and Zachary is still in overseas, right? Huh, Zach? Right, but that no problem. You can come and visit me anytime. I can give you the aura. Same goes to all of you. If you need help after today's lesson, you say, Uncle Raymond, I need some help from you, this, that, and that. Please do not, I repeat, do not hesitate to WhatsApp me and call me. And I will go the extra mile to run with you the marathon. It's up to you. It's your exam. You are fighting with 30 over 1,000 students in Singapore to get a good result. And the place that you want. JC and Poly. Part two, spoken interaction. Candidates engage in a discussion with the examiner on the topic broadly related to the video clip used in part one. They will not be asked any question about what people say in the video clip. Not necessary. I disagree. Sometimes you never know. Out of the examiner may forgot and ask you this kind of question. Huh? My teacher never tell me this. You have to anticipate the unanticipated thing. 你要未雨绸缪, you cannot just prepare yourself, please. All right, take it from there. And by the way, I'm not sure last week did I share with you I took a Grab. Did I share with you I took a Grab? No? I took a Grab to go to Plaza Singapura. Was it Plaza Singapura? Yes. First time in my life I took a Grab with BMW. No, I didn't share this, Nigel, did I share this? Yes or no? No, so this uncle tell me, oh, you're ex-teacher, yes. Can I ask you, Raymond, Singaporean students, kids don't like to talk a lot. You put them with the Indian student from India, China student from China, or Vietnam students, or a Malaysia student, most likely they will talk better than Singaporean. I do agree. I do agree. I don't know why Singaporean kids don't like to talk too much or scared to talk. Then good luck to you. You realize the Lao Wai, the white foreigner, which I'm mixed with, I think you can ask your parents. They like to talk a lot. They like to present themselves. You go and see any country, or not the country, any companies. Okay, you are going to be your own boss. So you need to engage and talk. Okay, let's go. So assessment objective for paper four. Please take note that I'm not interested for the 3 marks. We have talked about 4 to 5 marks. Let's talk about 4 marks, about development and organization of ideas. So you can do well in paper 1, 2, and 3, right? All the prata, all the one master and three slaves, the cut 3 words for visual editing, using your SMART, the setting, main characters, atmosphere, reader, and title for your essay 1, argumentative, essay, descriptive, but this one is totally different. You have to impress to express, not to depress and stress. Right now, you need to impress to express, not to depress and stress. So for 4 months, a thoughtful response, which is generally well-developed, organized, use a range of largely appropriate vocabulary and structures. A well-considered response, which is well-developed and organized, use a wide range of well-chosen vocabulary and structures. Now you know why, ladies and gentlemen, sometimes you use this one here. It's so important.
You 所谓俗话说得好,眼睛不如净灵,有时候是,有些人会至少门前显,还是雪中送炭,那我有经过这一列的问题,在疫情当中,我家人中了疫情,可是亲戚朋友每个都很怕,因为他们自己本身也是遇到疫情,可是我的灵柩就奋不顾身的就打包给我们吃,照顾我们,无微不至。You see, that's a good start, you see? 你明白吗?你不要忘记了,宝贝,当场在那个 exam hall, 你有十几个人在跟你抢那个饭碗,那个分数。你不要忘记了,宝贝,你再去 interview 找工作的时候,那边有十几个 candidate 在抢那个工作, 9000块的工作。 So what, you're Harvard, man? So what, you're Cambridge or NUS first class honor degree, man? 你鸡蛋糕,你不会讲话,你也是拿不到这个工作。 看你们每个脸都是很 nut nut face 的,书呆子的,会讲话吗? 真的,Emily,你会讲话,你不要看到,你最近你的眼睛很大力,很可爱,笑容很美,不错,你已经赢了那个 interviewer 了,可是当你讲话的时候,你吞吞吐吐, you cannot, well, I think, next! 你没有遇过这些 interviewer 啊? The real world is like that, sorry, you're here, you got a degree and you can't talk, you can't present. I don't know how you get your degree, no? I'm so sorry. Maybe you can go back and think about it. I'm so sorry you can't get this job. Right to point blank, oh, they don't give you face there. So think about it. This 30 marks is 很容易拿的. Your pronunciation and fluency and intonation is very important. You say, actually, I know this one very good. Because good luck to you, man, bro. I got students say, Uncle Raymond, I slang. My teacher say no. You know what I say, Blake? Ask your teacher to go and fly kite. Are you going to talk like that? Wait, you ask me a question. Ask me a question now. Quick lah. Wait, are you there? Ask me a question.
Yeah.
随便, 随便.
Okay.
你
Do you
连问
take
都
a
不会
graduate?
问，你连知己知彼，百战不殆，你连自己都不懂怎么问 question。Sorry 啊，Wait, all of you, don't get me angry 哦。I have to discipline you 哦。你啊，哎，Wait，欺负是啊，懂哦？哈哈，来。
Do you take MRT yesterday?
Actually, yesterday, huh, I did not take MRT because very the crowded so I took my car to go for my duration. 你觉得我会 pass 吗？Wait, you think I will pass?
No.
Thanks. Okay, ask me again.
Do you take MRT yesterday?
Oh, sir. As a matter of fact, yesterday I was thinking twice to take the MRT because it's more convenient. I don't need to worry about the parking. But nevertheless, I decided to take my car because it's more convenient and I carry a few things. And I thought that it's going to be raining cats and dogs. Therefore, I decided to take a car instead of the MRT, sir. Can you answer like that? You think it's 很恶心嘞，很肉麻嘞。Then sorry 啦，guys. Good luck to you 咯。Okay, I'm so sorry. This is MOE. This is the teacher. Some of them might not take it. Some might think that you are 太过 hypocrite，很假，很虚伪，很什么。I'm not interested in just your O level oral. I'm interested in the real world out there. Right? Nigel, Emily, Greg, Zachary, and Shi Xian, and Chan Kun. Because these teachers have been in school for many years, who never go out to work in the real world. They will follow strictly to MOE guidelines, all these things here, which is totally 100% nothing wrong. Nothing wrong, but I'm just sharing with you the real world out there. Unless these teachers have been working outside world for many years, and then they change and convert into a teacher, then they will understand how the interviews are being conducted in the real world. Trust me. So there are nothing wrong to follow these guidelines, seriously. Next. We have the part two. So that is the part one later. You need to take note. No pause. Don't have too many pause. If you're not sure, just hold on. Don't do this kind of small little habits here. Not very good. Spoken interactions. Okay, we talk about 4 to 5 months. Communications, and this is the one just now break, you test me, right? So offer some thoughtful response with generally well-developed perspective. Use a range of largely appropriate vocabulary and structures. Are using raining cats and dogs, right? And nevertheless, as a matter of fact, generate clear pronunciation, engages in the discussion by responding appropriately to the prompts. Offers well-considered response with coherent and well-developed perspective. That's 5 marks. Use a wide range of well-chosen vocabulary and structures. So you see, your vocab now is seriously, instead of having time to play game, go and read the whole entire dictionary if you can. Trust me, it's super useful. Clear pronunciation, engage in sustained discussion, sometimes moving beyond the prompt. You see, I'll do that. That's not when Greg was asking me. I think I did give you this word before. I'm not sure you have seen this. Do you know what's the meaning of this word here? Okay, Blake, you asked me one question already. Now, Greg, show me. Everyone must ask me a question. Now, Suyen, you are in the plane, you cannot. You have to type and give me the questions. So it's an impromptu. Greg, show me a question now. Don't waste time, because
Do you
after that,
think we have
intern.
achieved a multiracial society?
Thank you. Don't waste time, because after that, I'm going for another meeting. Sorry, sir. I'm a bit too hesitate to answer you because as far as I'm concerned, living in Singapore, thank God I'm Singaporean. I feel that if you are talking about Singapore context, I would say yes, you have hit a milestone. In fact, I feel that the moment I walk on the street, I feel there's racial harmony. I will use the 3H. We are happy to see a diverse society in Singapore, a healthy relationship, and the most important, a very harmonious where you enjoy different religions and race holiday, sir. Thank you. Okay? Can I answer you within less than 5 seconds. Back to you, Emily. Show me a question. To prove that it works, to prove that I deserve to be your master, your teacher, to prove that I'm able to help you to improve your oral. So now you test me first to see I can answer within less than 5 seconds. For me, it's 5 seconds. For you, it's 10 seconds. 5 seconds. Back to you, Emily. These are all the questions that you never prepare one. It's now at this moment you prepare. Not like yesterday, the day before I asked you, I sent a message to you. Hey, Greg, send a question to me. Greg, send a question to me. Emily, your turn.
Many young people don't like to spend time with their family members. Do you agree with that?
Teacher, why I smile a guilty smile? Because I myself is one of them, teacher. Sadly to say, apparently I don't spend too much time with my family at this point of time because, yes, you know, I'm a latchkey child. Latchkey就是钥匙儿童. 就是daddy妈咪整天不在家，现在没有 latch key, 现在是 thumbprint. So most of the time, I'm alone with my helper. But teacher, if we have, in fact, we have a time to bond, a wheel of a time together, I will be on cloud nine because my dad always fly a lot because of business trip. My mom recently had to fly back to China because my grandma passed. My grandma kicked the bucket, so my grandfather is alone there, and being the only child, she has to take her responsibility and filial piety. So I need to be independent, innovative, and of course, initiative to do my thing. So I would answer your question, not just me, teacher, but most of my friends more or less have the same, like my situations, that we have lesser time to bond with family members. But I would like to assure myself that after the O-level examination, I not only want to work part-time to buy my parents a good meal, at the same time, I would like to have more time, more bonding. I will use the ABC, a very awesome, beautiful, and caring relationship with my parents. Thank you, teacher. Back to you, Nigel.
Do you think that you would like to live your life as a street artist? Why or why not?
If you tell me, okay, now I will take it as Uncle Raymond. Okay? Because these questions, very close to me. I love to write songs. The snow is falling, the wind is coming, and Christmas time is approaching. That's one of my lyrics. I know it well, and I can tell. Every little thing that fell onto my head. So can't you see what will be, what will happen to me? I like to write songs. I actually have one. My dream is to become a lawyer, a criminal lawyer. And at the same time, I like to sing. Sadly to say, 30 years ago, we don't have basking. We don't have street performance. But if I could turn back the clock, sir, Nigel. Yes, because it's one way to show your DEF, your desire to be a street artist. E will be the excellent and opportunity for me to showcase my products. And I don't need to pay rental. It's on the street, people can see and or passerby. And then F will be very flourish if my products or my masterpiece or my drawing can be appreciated. Same thing to my songs. Because nowadays, we have all walks of life, and if you think whether it's feasible or not, it's like what we call one man's meat is another man's poison. One man's treasure is another man's trash. But to answer your questions, yes, I would definitely love to have this a golden opportunity because it kind of opened up my world. Thank you, sir. Zachary, your turn. These are Si Xian. If you can you type your questions first and don't hit enter so that I can answer your question later. Nice, Zachary.
Would your parents support you doing non-standard sports?
Would your parents support you in what?
Doing non-standard sports.
Non-standard sport, is it? Did you say non-standard sport?
Yes.
How you define the non-standard sports to you, sir?
Sports that you don't do like every day, like for example, like rock climbing and stuff.
Okay. So this is your definition, sir. My non-standard sport is like related. So now I'm a student. Well, as you know, different school is very unique. They have a different range of sports. For me, my parents will advocate and support me as long the sport can keep me physically, emotionally, psychologically, mentally well prepared for my exam, for my future, for my health, for my well-being? Yes, they will. But then again, recently I was taking wakeboarding. You know, it's wakeboarding, right? In East Coast Park, where it's like a surfing. They feel that it is very risky. It will hurt me, and it's pretty expensive. But financially, it's not an issue. But they are more concerned with this non-standard sport because they feel that it's not related to my CCA and not able to allow me to go for my DSA. Therefore, there's always two sides of the coin, the double-edged sword. Thank you, sir. How can Singapore improve its public transport system to make sure people can have a smoother and faster trip? Now, I will use it as a student, Mr. Xian. I'm not sure about any other people. As far as I'm concerned, I do not travel far and wide to the whole world. Only a couple of countries that I visited. As far as I'm concerned, in my personal opinion, I feel that Singapore has really hit certain milestones to improve the public transport. Of course, there are some teething issue. Of course, there are some ups and downs. Of course, there's some hiccups. Even though we have all these unforeseen circumstances, I strongly believe the governments in Singapore and the people who support the public transport has done their utmost best with their best to beat the very difficult test in order to, number one, to have the 3S, to have a safe, smooth, and super transport system, because we are always in a rat race, especially in the morning, going to schools, going to work, going to do whatever business meeting. So yes, I won't say it's 100% smooth and fast, but at least they can bring me from point A to point B in a safe, smooth, and super, or maybe very systematic journey. I would say thank God. I'm very happy about it. Thank you, sir. So I tested with you. I tested the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 questions. Less than 5 seconds. Never plan. Of course, you say, Blake, 你是老师吗? 鸡蛋糕你当然会的吗? 我给你三步诗你都会走。 对吗? 人之初性本善, 对吗? 我都讲了。 各位大哥大姐, 你的不难的, 只要你在你的脑海里, 找到那个九个朋友, where, what, who, when, who, which, how. Alright? Later, I'll teach you, This is the part a lot of students are very afraid, because the two examiners are alien, first time never seen in their life. So let's go for this one here. Let's watch the video. Are you able to watch the video now? 1, 2, go. Okay, this is from the SEAB, the sample. Okay, now let me ask all of you questions. I will call names. Whoever go first is, let's put it this way. Let's be fair. I won't say lady first. Be fair. Don't bully Emily. Emily will be last. Fair enough. Okay. So now you all have the five of you, five boys. Scissors, paper, stone. Craig, you're the first one. Okay, second one. Scissors, paper, stone. Zachary, your second one. Huh? I don't even scissors, paper, stone. Why you tell me I'm second one? Because Uncle Raymond decides. Scissors, paper, stone. Ah, Shishen, third one. Okay, Blake and Nigel, now you can do scissors, scissors, paper, stone. Now come, I two of you. Show your hand. Scissors, paper, stone. Scissors, paper, stone. Scissors, paper, stone. Ah, you sold out. So, Blake, three whole week. Okay, Craig. Okay, don't mind. This is just, I will help you. They will deliver a planned response to up to 2 minutes to the following prompts. Okay, now, I want all of you to write on a piece of paper, does making a living as a street artist or street performer appeal to you? Why or why not? So Nigel, you asked me this question just now, right? But I did not really answer to that. I'm using my own answer. Is it really wrong or does it make sense? Candidates can make notes on the paper provided and refer to them during the examination. Their notes will not be assessed. At the end of the examination, the notes must be handed to the examiner. So guys, I want you to write the 9, 8, W, and 1 H now. Who, why, when, which, 9 questions. Then on top of that, Emily, use a so then how. So I think street performance is not appealing to me. Of course, why not, right? So I don't think so. It doesn't appeal to me. Then, in my opinion, because I feel that it's a waste of time. How come? Because if they are good artists, why don't they just get the job to join an anime company or Genshin's company to draw the good design? Why are they spending time on the street and loitering around and they can't even really make a good living out of it? If it's a hobby, I got nothing to say. But to me, it's not appealing to me. You see? Emily, you don't answer. You don't expect that I come to say why not, right? So if you dare to say why not, sometime, Blake, Greg, Zixian, Zachary, Nigel, and Changken, and Emily, the examiner might be, wait, Ling Yan Xiang Kan. Do you think Uncle Raymond is handsome? No, definitely she's the ugly shit, man. Definitely is so ugly, but he has the brain, so I wouldn't be surprised. Get it? Jung, write down. Then, Greg, you'll be the first one talking, So I want Emily, Nigel, Zachary, Zixian, and Blake to give comments to Greg. So everyone will have 60 marks on Greg. So the highest is 10 marks, the lousiest is less than 5 marks, okay? So be honest, you don't just give for the sake of 0 marks and 1 marks. Is my lesson so boring? Zachary and Nigel are yawning with me. You see, your yawn also affected me. Oh my god. 2 minutes,
Can I rewatch the video?
No. In the exam, can you rewatch that?
Yeah.
Can I?
We're given 10 minutes to think.
Can I? Okay, well, if you say can, no problem. Okay, one more time. Usually, I don't allow to. To be honest, don't mind. Let's go. Okay, Ken, great. Hey, great. Are you there? Mr. Greg, are you there? Great, are you there, Greg?
Nigel, don't cry, Nigel. Just all only, don't cry. Oh, good boy, la. Good boy, don't cry. Okay, don't cry. Blake, you enjoy your music. Nisu, what the shell you're shopping for? Yes, you. I like the way you're easy go, easy lucky, easy going, easy come, easy go. Relax a bit, huh? Good. Okay, great. Are you ready for the 2 minutes? Who is next, huh? Nigel, right? No. Is it Blake? No. Is that right? Okay. I can't wait for Greg now, so I need to let you start first. Go. It's a matter of time. Whoever starts still, okay? Come, let's go. This is the first time, before your O-level. And in school, you might not have enough practice for this. Go. Zachary, move your mouse, your mic, your mouth close to the mic. Let's go. So you know the question already, right?
No, I can't repeat that question.
Wait, I let share screen first. Okay, Ken? Does making a living as a street artist or street performer appeal to you?
No, not really. First of all, I do not really like art, and like I don't really have like a talent in art. So I feel like being a street artist, like I won't really be good at it. But if I was to take it as like a hobby, right, then maybe I would consider, like, for example, if let's say after finishing GC and like I have to wait, like, to go to the army and I have, like, nothing to do. I won't mind, like, making some money off street artist, of being a street artist or a street performer for, like, a month or two. So, but as a living, I think, no, not really. I won't make a living as a street artist or street performer.
You still got 1 more minute?
Oh,
you need 2 minutes, right? Respond to up to 2 minutes, right? Mm. The more you say, the more marks. The less you say, the less marks.
I also feel like a lot of people, like as a Singaporean, right? A lot of people in the public won't like be interested. So I feel like the money that I'll be making is also like very little, and it won't be enough for me to like live my life, you know, and. I really do.
That's all?
Yeah, that's
all. Okay, you cannot use the word as a Singaporean. You cannot represent every Singaporean. So maybe you can say maybe in Singapore, this kind of street artists and performance, street performance may have their own limitations, and the support here, in my personal opinion, may not be so strong. But I can see slowly and surely, write down these three words, slowly and surely and definitely, this kind of artist and performance will get acknowledged and be recognized eventually. All right, thank you. I will give you 7 out of 10. The rest, can you type and send in the Zoom chat and give our dear friend the mark now? Thank you. So everyone must type out of 10, I give 7 upon 10. The PT marks, the PD, bloody hell PT marks. Okay, Greg, are you ready now, Greg? Wow, all give 7, well done. So Shen, eh? Wow, session 8 lah. Wow, Greg, are you there? Oh my god, I have been asking so many times. Okay, so Greg cannot respond. Who is next, huh? Session, right? Your turn. Are you able to unmute and talk? Greg, are you there, Greg?
Can you hear me?
Yes.
Sorry, I went lagging.
Okay, so can you restart? I want to see your face. Okay, now go. Okay, great, your turn. After that, Su Xian, if you really cannot talk for whatever reason, please start typing your answer in. Thank you. Great, your turn. Does making a living as a street artist or street performer appeal to you? Why or why not? 2 minutes starting from now.
It doesn't appeal to me as there are many other effects that I need to consider. For example, the weather. If the weather is bad or it's raining cats and dogs, I won't be able to put up a street performance or to display my artwork in the public for people to buy. And I find that living as a street artist or street performer doesn't give you a stable income, and it's also decide on the stock market whether it is interesting for the people in the public to buy or whether it's not. And to me, I think living as a street artist or street performer, you need to have a certain level of skills to appeal others, or else people may not even look at you in the public. Yeah. So hence, I don't think living as a street artist or street performer appeal to me.
Okay, I will give 8 upon 10, even though it's not even more than 1 minute. Okay, 8 upon 10, good start, great, very cool, very relaxed, even though you're a bit idona. I need more practice, great, thank you. How about the rest? Give marks now, thank you. Give marks to great Zachary, Nigel, Emily, Blake, thank you. Wow, hey, which one is copycat water, huh? 我8分，你8分啊？你讨厌 ？Okay，哇，ten upon ten 啊！哦，哎，Great，你是收买他？开玩笑，开玩笑。哎，This is a confident to you 啊。I mean, I believe strongly believe all your these leaders here, your friends here, who really as a, not just encourage you, they know what they give 啊。So those of you who know how to give, next, Su Xian, are your turn. Are you able? Just type lah. You say yes or no. If no, then I'll skip. Don't worry, Su Xian. We got 来世翻盘,对吗? No, okay, don't worry, my dear. Now, Blake, your turn. Hey, Emerson, Nigel, your turn.
Nigel.
Nigel, sorry. Nigel, wow, just now you told me this question, right? Now I show you back this question. Okay, go. Okay,
No,
serious, serious, serious. Serious. Ready, 3, 2, 1, go.
I feel that living as a street performer or street artist will not appeal to me. And there's a few reasons to this. First, as being a street artist or street performer, right, also the profit you make or like the money you make actually really depends on what other people think about your skills or your work. Because if your work, like what you do, like art or you perform, just so happens that people likes it, then you will earn more money. But if people do not like it, you'll just be earning very less, or you might not even earn at all. So and then second thing is, if you're street artists and street performers usually work in the outdoors, and this is and their work will be very affected by the weather outside. So if it starts to rain or the weather turns bad, I mean you have to stop your performance or whatever you're doing, and then you have to move to a shelter place. And the shelter place probably will be very crowded, and then you'll be competing with a lot of other people, and then yeah, you make your business worse. Also, if you want to be a street artist or street performer, you have to have a skill that your like you're confident in. I mean, many people like feel that they have the skills to do it, but end up it's just not enough. To appeal to people, it's not good enough for it. So, and the competition between them is very high. So that's why living as a street artist or street performer does not appeal to me.
Thank you. 8.8 for you. Marks, please, for Nigel. Thank you, Nigel. You have a few good points, like saying that the competition is actually healthy. Whether it is raining or not raining, or you move to a certain place, the moment you step into primary one, don't say K1, K2, the moment you step in primary one, you already have competition all the way through your life. Competition for a job, competition for buying a house, anything. There will definitely have competition, but whether this competition is healthy or not, it all depends on the individual. But you bring out the point that, you know, it's not really good for money, for income, but at least they have something to do. Back to you, Blake. I will give 8.8. The rest, please give marks to our dear friend. Please don't be so stingy and selfish. I say give marks means really give marks. No, thanks. Next, Blake, your turn.
Okay. I think making living as a street artist or street performer appeal to me. Because first of all, it provides freedom to express yourself. For example, in the real life, you didn't have so much occasion to express yourself on a stage. So if you work as a street performer or street artist, you have the ability to strengthen your talent for the art or the skills you have without have any certificate. And if you like perform very good, it will attract many visitors or passerbys to be the onlookers. Then they will give you the certain money, and also street artist is more accessible and cheaper for some families that could not afford like to buying a real picture or to sing a real like orchestra was performs in a legal state. Because it is on the street, so it is everyone can see it, so it is very accessible and also cheaper, because there's no certificate, as I think there's no certificate. So as you know, if drawing you have to draw something, then it will be much cheaper than the price that's sold on the formal galleries. And last point is that if you are more talent or professional in it, you can get a higher income or higher or got a lot of money through this through this street performer, because everyone will be attracted to your performance, and they will give you the money that you want. So
thank you. I will give Blake 5 upon 10. What, Nigel? 5 upon 10. Okay, that you saw my message, huh? Okay, I will give Blake 5 upon 10. Okay, Blake, can you say this in Mandarin, Chinese? Hey, the rest, how many marks you're supposed to give, Blake? Give your marks now. Blake, are you ready to say in Chinese?
No, because at first I plan in English, so I'm not.
No, 我现在要你讲华文。用华文来翻译。开始，你是高华对吗
Yeah.
？OK，来开始。
Now.
不然是 Christmas 啊，现在啦，这样。
就是我觉得，做个街头艺人或者街头美术家，我觉得是一种不错的现象，因为这样的话，这样可以给我们有更多的机会去展示自己，去表现自己，对所有的观众。如果你有对这方面的天，好比说你有对这方面的天赋，或者是有那种大师级别的这种模范的话，你可以吸引更多的观众。这样的话，让你的就是可以让你的表演变得更精彩。然后呢，然后路人或者是其他的路人的话，都可以来看你的表演。这样的话，也可以增加你的这个增加你的薪水或工资并且如果你是一个街头艺人的话，你不需要考任何的证明，或者是有或者是有什么有画师资格证之类的，所以呢，你就可以专门在街头开一个小店，专门为人画像。这样的话，虽然比较便宜，但是呢，人们肯定会买你的画，因为有些人买不起从画廊里头买的画过来的画，所以他们就会去像你这种街头小画师的店里面去购买更便宜的，然后更有途径的画，所以对。
Are you ready? Your turn, Emily. 你未来。Let's go.
No, I don't think living as a street artist or street performer appeal to me. Firstly, I'm a shy person, so I'm
Really,
always
man?
about how others think of me.
Kidding, just kidding. Sorry to interrupt you. Okay, carry on.
I'm
Yeah.
afraid of how the public will judge my artworks or performances, so I will get very awkward and tense in front of them. So this will heavily affect my performance level, and I will not be able to freely express myself to my fullest potential. I also remember that I would already be shivering in fear and break into cold sweat just by presenting in front of my class. So I think I can kiss goodbye to becoming a street performer.
Damn it, okay, some more.
Secondly, being a street artist or street performer, will probably have an unstable income, because usually in the streets, most of the public will be busy with their lives and have little to no time to stop by and watch me perform. My artwork and performances may also not appeal to the public, as everyone has different tastes, so my income will be limited, and hence I cannot really enjoy my life if I were to make a living as a street artist or street performer.
That's all.
Yeah, I think.
So my advice is once on that day, the actual exam, when you have nothing to say, well, I think that's about it. That's all, teacher. Thank you very much. Say this, I think that's all. Thank you very much. That's about it. Thank you, teacher. Okay,
Okay.
so because the teacher might hear, don't think, Hayuma. Okay. That's all. I will give you 7.9. By right, you're supposed to get 8.3, but I minus 0.3 marks from you, Emily. Reason is because I'm a person, I prefer positive. So there's one sentence you say wrongly. I'm a shy person, therefore I cannot do this. Hello? Who is not shy? Don't give the examiner a chance to attack you back. No doubt I'm a very shy and very timid person, but Nevertheless, if circumstances and situation wants me to do that, I will take away my shyness and do my best to perform it. Take, for example, in school project, I'm a very shy person, but I was tasked to be the first speaker, and it was so competitive because the rest of the group did very well. But given these situations, I have to put my shyness and put my bravery out front to ensure that my group get the best mark. You see, Dong Ma, Emily, 不要记住啊，你再去 interview 的时候，每个人都是 put on their best show for the interviewer. 所以你不可以把你自己弄到很低级. By putting yourself humble, it doesn't make good things to you. People will look at you, oh, so 你这个是没有 confident 的人啊，请你来做么？ Shy 啊，shy 不可以当饭吃的嘞。 我也是很 shy 啦，可是我没办法啊。一个月工资1万块了，你不要啊？ 好，明白啊， Emily. Well done, well said. Thank you very much. That is part one. The part two will be a bit different already. I will just anyhow point anyone to do. So, Greg, you're not the first one. Okay, let's go. Examiner must use all the prompts provided to invite candidates to give their response and consider different viewpoints. When appropriate, examiner should also pursue any points candidate. So these are the two questions they ask. I will ask Sishen, you want, you can type in. I won't interrupt you. So if you feel like you got answer something, just type in. I would love it. So Blake, can you read the question for number A, please?
A, is it?
Yeah, A.
Okay. Would your parents or other adults share your views about making a living as a street artist or street performer? Why or why not?
Emily? Answer? In 5 seconds, go.
Teacher, can I ask a question?
Huh?
Can I ask a question first?
There, the question is there. Hey.
I don't really get what the question meant by share your views.
So sorry, you don't get what?
I don't really get what the question meant by share your views. Is it like support or not support?
Go ahead, I won't tell you first. Okay, don't worry. Imagine now this is an exam. You cannot ask the examiner question like that. Just use your imagination and creativity. Go.
I think my parents would support my decision about making a living as a street artist or street performer. Because firstly, I think I am quite good at art. So I think they are quite confident in my art skills. So I think they would.
That's all?
No. I think they would think that I will have no problem making a living as a street artist. And they would prioritize my happiness first. So if I sincerely want to make a living as a street artist, I think they will fully support my decision in doing so.
Yeah, you get it ready. So if you ask the teacher about what you mean by share the view, they might already discount your mark already. So the very smart move, Emily, well done. So in future, if you encounter this kind of situation that you're not sure with the question, you can use three things right now. I think, in my opinion, that one is the best. As a matter of fact, I hesitate to answer because I have two different views. You get it? Right now, As a matter of fact, I hesitate because I have two different views. One is a positive and negative view. Get it? Just like you did in your social study. Okay. Is it reliable or not reliable? Useful or not reliable? Not useful or not useful? Surprised or not surprised? Get it up. So answer two sides of the coin. There's always two sides of the coin. You can say double-edged sword. You can say there's a brain and room that depends on technology. Thing. Well said, man. 8.8 for you. Well done. Next, may I, Zachary, what is A? What do you think, A?
I think, no, not really. Because, firstly, I think my friends who love, we would like me to have, like, a normal job. And one that, like, don't require, like, so much risk taking, because I think a street performer, you can't really have like steady income, because it's really maybe dependent on how the public views your artwork, or like how well you present it out to them. And it's not really like much about like your talent has something to do with how much you sell, but I think mostly it's like how much time the public has, or like what the public wants to do. And I think my friends would love me to have like a more normal job and not so like risky, because I need to like make a steady income for myself. As like an only child, I'm like basically I'm the only person who can like probably take care of them when they are older. So I think they won't like want me to have, and they won't want me to make a living as a street artist or a street performer. But if it's like for example a part time job, then maybe sure I could. Yeah, I think that's all. Thank you.
Well done. Thank you. At least you say thank you. Okay, fine enough. Yes, it is true that sometimes, because of the society that we live in here, Zach, and being the only child, you have a big responsibility. And if, let's say, this student, not you or anybody, it can be you, that you have a family business to run, you have some things to follow up with your family business, things like that, you must be the next in line, the heir of the successor of this. Then, sorry, you have to give up all these kind of street performance and street artists, whatever you like is your hobby. Yes, it's not easy, but it's a big dilemma. To answer your question, Greg, but O-level can, man, I taught in school only. Yes, O-level can, but the things they will give you discount with it. Okay, they will discount your mark. So it's better to reface it if you're not sure, than anyhow answer. And what happens if you answer wrongly, then that's it. But thank God, just now Emily, I don't want to tell her what you mean by your share your views. So she managed to use the word I think, I feel. Right now, I think, I feel, as a matter of fact, I hesitate to answer because I feel that there's a few different viewpoints. Then pause that. Then the teacher will ask, what kind of viewpoints do you think? Good or bad? Ah, then you know already. Okay, advantages and disadvantages. 对吗? 从那个口中, 从那个examiner讲出来. So you say, I'm so sorry, teacher, I do not know this question very well. Can you rephrase it? They will rephrase. Nothing wrong. They will say, huh, why are you so stupid? So simple, also don't know, then I take your O-level oral for what? They won't say that, of course. They'll say, well, what it means that, what is your opinion? What is your suggestion? Okay, thank you. How about you, Nigel?
My parents would definitely not share my views about making a living as a street artist, a street performer. Because ever since I'm growing up, my dad always told me not to be like an artist or like a singer. He said he feel that this kind of job are not lasting and it can crash or like be destroyed like in a blink of an eye. Like one day people just stop listening to you or stop liking what you do. Your career would just be ended, and it's very so making like being a street artist and street performer a very unstable job. And he feel that those artists and street performers, most of them only get recognized after they are dead, like all the famous artists.
Okay, sorry, okay, I love because I also think like your dad, to be honest. Okay, carry on.
And
you remind me of Michelangelo and Leonardo da Vinci. Sorry, carry on. Yeah, so sorry. Yes.
So he feel that there's no point being an artist because, I mean, after you pass on, what can you do with your fame? You can't do anything. And then my mom also share the same view as him. They all feel that it's too unstable to be a proper job, and I might just lose it anytime, and then I'll be living on the streets if I lose the job. Yeah, then.
Hey, high five to your mom and dad, man. Hey, but can you go and tell your mom and dad, say Uncle Raymond's cousin did very well, no? Uncle Raymond's cousin is Michael Jackson, Taylor Swift, Zhou Huajian, Zhang Guorong, Zhang Xueyou, Tan Yongling. All my cousins did very well on this thing. Oh, later. Oh, my cousin Michael Jackson did very well. You want to be racist? Michael Jackson cannot be my cousin. This is just joking. Even they are all the famous singers, they are making tons of money, like Jeff Wong, Jackson Wang, okay, Zhou Huajian, Liu Dehua, all these people, they are making tons of money through singing. Even they sing until now, they also make tons of money. But how many of us can be like them? And you have to understand their platform in their country, they can do that. Singapore singer, to be honest, so far, my friend is a singer, Nigel. She's a singer. She went to 中国好声音 PK with JJ. JJ 是谁啊? 周谁啊? 不是周杰伦啊, 周什么? 林俊杰, 对不起, 林俊杰, 你懂啊? So you see, there are some Singapore singers that are doing very well. How many of them do you see? In fact, I know a lot of them are singing very well, good. True enough, because their mentality is the same as Uncle Raymond's mentality. Nothing wrong. But 每个人都是行行出状元, right? If you can sometimes sing on the street and you can happen to be recognized by some famous people, whoever, some celebrities or entertainment business people, you might get famous also. True enough, you might not sing forever. Same as the sport people, the footballer, the tennis player, or the swimmer, the gymnastic, they only last for not long. Same thing. Any job is also, unless you are being your own boss. So not wrong to say that. Thank you very much. Blake, stay ready. Blake, your turn. Blake, 你讲了吗? 讲了? 还没有?
No.
Okay. Yeah. Question A. What do you think?
No, my parents will not support me for make a living as a street artist or street performer. Because for first and foremost, because making a living in the street seem impossible for teenagers and youngsters today, because the society, we need a lot of money to create family and get married and to bring up children. So we so I make a street for a living, there will be less money to get these things done. Therefore, I think that make a street living today is impossible due to the income and the money barrage. Secondly, I thought my parents will oppose my views because they think this is like untraditional way of getting in the money and achieve successful in one's life. They think that the traditional way of getting the money is like a doctor or lawyer or some the jobs that will be respected by peoples and the societies. However, the street artists or the street performers could be deemed as unhealthy or a rural way of trying to get in the money. Although it's make a living for yourself, but in others people's opinion it may be different. Thank you for listening to my speech.
Awesome, man. Well done. Much better than the first one. Now you get it up. Confident. Do not pause. 用你的华文去想先，想完了用华文去 convert to English. So 刚才我那个 test 给你就是知道，你看。 你讲到头头是道用华文, so same thing, do that. A bit tough for you, Blake, more time consuming, but definitely is worth it. Because in the long run, 如果有一个公司要请做翻译员还是做的, 你是第一个选择啊,大哥, 感恩, 感谢, 感激, 感动, next one, Emily, read question number two, please. The last part of today's lesson.
Would you say that the people in your country are interested in activities related to the arts, such as visiting a museum or watching a play? Why do you say so?
Zachary, you start first.
Why?
Why do I pick you up? Because your alphabet starts with Z, ma. So I don't want you to let you up. You're very naughty, oh, Zachary, I'm very naughty. 快点啊！不可以讲，马上要讲了。 Sorry.
Wait.
You cannot wait leh. In the same, you tell the teacher wait lah. Say, well, in my opinion, continue to talk like that. Come on, don't stop. Well, in my opinion.
In my opinion, I think it really depends on the personality of the person. But I think majority of Singaporeans won't really prefer doing art. Like making a living through art, because like, wait, can we start? Am I allowed to? Okay.
Okay.
In my opinion, I think the people in my country are won't really be interested in doing activities related to the art as a living. However, I think they would be interested in activities like these if it was like watching other people perform or stuff. An example is the Coldplay and Taylor Swift concerts. I think that's happening next year. The tickets sold out very quickly and like a lot of people were like trying to buy tickets off each other and stuff. However, if it come to like small concerts, like for example, there was a talent show in my school, and like the teacher wanted students to sign up and register for it. However, like not many students participated and registered for it. So I think people would be more interested in like activities such as visiting a museum or watching a play instead of having to perform it themselves. I think the main reason is because people are too afraid that there are other people judging them, or that there or that they don't have like the self confidence to do so. I think that's the reason why. Thank you.
Instead of using I think, instead of using thing, you can say apparently, well, basically, concurrently, consequently, definitely, eventually, frequently, graciously, honestly, in my opinion, honestly, use this word, the li. Instead of thing, I think. Well, as a matter of fact, nevertheless, task, hence, therefore, these are the words, very good. Huh? No, please, hey, shut up, that you did a good job, okay? Hey, please, for goodness sake, the more you have negative yourself, you're going to kill your brain cell, kill yourself, kill your confidence. You have no time to go and curse and swear yourself that my bad. You become very bad, you become very sad, and make everyone mad. Nobody is glad, and end up who is going to tell your dad. Okay, well done, Zachary. Back to you, Blake, your turn. You never see I come from, huh? Yeah.
Yeah, I would say that my people in my country are interested in activities related to arts, such as visiting a museum, watching a play, because for first and foremost, China is a country where from Asian people are more related to the artistic artistic, yeah. So there's a lot of development in the Asian history. And this is based on the history saying, and also to the recent people in China also like arts or perform because they think they can show their talent while they are the would have the great opportunity to show their themselves also. Secondly, I think my country, I think the people in my country like to watching a play because watching a play really relaxes one's mood and mind after an exhausting day, and also based on the studies shown in 2002, there will be less people watching the play than do not watching a play to become less stressed in the China's government statics. Okay, thank you for listening to my speech.
Thank you, thank you. Blade, are you Singaporean or holding a student pass?
Student pass.
Oh, okay, then thank God. If you are holding a Singapore IC or PR, a vice versa is not about Singapore. But if you are holding a student pass, nothing wrong to say about China. So you will score from there. Okay, that's my personal opinion. Thank you, Blake. Very good. 8 upon 8. Hello. 8 upon 8.8 8 upon 10. Back to you. Greg, your turn.
I think the people in my country are interested in activities related to arts and visiting a museum or watching a play. First of all, visiting a museum, it gives you it helps you to gain more knowledge about the past and more knowledge and some knowledge about what's going to happen in the future also. For example, you can just go to the National Museum and you can see all the vibrant arts that is being displayed during the World War. And in Singapore context, visiting a museum sometimes it is not just the same artifact, it may also change. So it also gives people the opportunity to visit the museum more than once. And watching a play also helps to de-stress the people in my country, and also gives my country economic growth, as watching a play needs a lot of money and time and effort to put in. I would say in arts, there is in my country there is very less opportunities that we can visit to the arts, but I would say that people are still interested in arts, yeah, given an opportunity to visit. Yeah, thank you.
9 upon 10. Well done. Emily, your turn.
I would say that people in my country are interested in activities related to the arts. Because firstly, every time when I visit a museum, it's always flooded with people, packed like sardines. And I always see them listening carefully to like the professional speaking, introducing about the museum. And I will always see them taking down notes, and they are always very engaged into the speaker and the talk. My parents and my relatives, we all like to visit all sorts of museums, like the Art and Science Museum, the Museum of Ice Cream, the National Gallery, and we will always invite our friends over to come. And I will say that my family circle here, we all like to visit museums. Oh, and another example is the upcoming Taylor Swift concert. I myself is a Swiftie, there was like a lot of competition between the Swifties to get our tickets. Unfortunately, I did not get it, but it's fine. So I went to Telegram, and there was a chat created solely for like the trading and selling and buying of tickets. There were like 20,000 people in the chat. Yeah. So from there I can see that a lot of people are interested in concerts and plays. Yeah. I'm done.
9.5. Well done. Well done. Emily, honestly, yeah. From your the bottom of your heart, the whole truth, nothing but the sincere truth. Do you talk like that in school presentation?
I don't know.
Were you given a chance to talk like that in front of a class or on the stage?
Yeah. Actually, I'm the vice chairperson of my class.
Vice chairperson of your class in what?
Like overall, like the whole class. So I have a lot of chances to talk.
Well done. Please continue. I think the only thing you lack of is two things. Three things. One is your gesture. You need to. Number two is I cannot see your eye contact, how you look it. The three is how you position yourself during your speech. So this is, if you can have a chance, I will share with you more. Okay? So I'm not sure whether your teacher in school teach you how to do your presentation, how to walk around in the class, how to get engaged, that the audience will listen to you. How do you see when the person are not interested or where they are interested in what you say, how you're going to engage. Okay, this is a technique. Because this will definitely help you, especially Emily, with your good look, good brain, good nature. Any company will employ you to give a speech to people, will get the good customer vibe for the company. Well done. And I like the example. Well, I got one student who wanted to buy Taylor Swift ticket. My son bought 3 tickets, managed to get it. Okay, I don't know how you get it. So I'm looking around for people who are interested in Taylor Swift ticket, including yourself. If I can get, I will let you know. Seriously. Because I promised that boy to have the free ticket for him. Not cheap. Okay. So I'm looking around for that. Seriously. I'm not kidding. Because I do have ex-student working in this kind of on entertainment scene. So I've seen. Nah, 不是那种黑市, I'm not talking about black market. I'm talking about legal market. Please. Legally one. Last but not least, Nigel. Let's go. Nigel, you're the last one, right? Let's go.
I feel that people in my country are very interested in activities related to arts, like visiting a museum or watching a play. Despite my opinion on being on arts, but then why do I say this? Because whenever you visit like art museum or some place that people perform, there's surprisingly always a lot of people there, watching like the performance or looking at the art museum or something. This shows that people are actually interested in these activities. And also, there was once where I went for a performance, at a theater. Although I thought there would not be like a lot of people going to watch the performance, but surprisingly the place was actually packed. Like the whole theater was full and there's like a lot of people watching. And they were all like very interested in every performance that played that day. They listen properly and this shows their interest in the performance, which also make me feel that people are actually interested in activities related to arts.
That's all?
Yeah.
Thank you. 7.5, well done. Maybe you are too tired already. I can tell you the way you talk, a bit not lagging, but you know. Maybe you poor thing, you haven't taken your breakfast, right?
I take on breakfast.
No, your mom just sent me, my dear Nigel, poor thing, to attend your class so early, he did not have a proper breakfast. Later, mommy will bring Nigel to eat Happy Meal McDonald's with a toy. My brain is not small. Just because you don't have the Happy Meal, is it? Or the toy? Nigel不可以有一个toy吗?哇,真是的哦。 我的儿子这么大，28岁，还有一个unicorn toy， 还有 Stitch。 Uncle Raymond 还有一个 teddy bear 很 cute 的嘞，像我这么 cute。OK， Blake will be Uncle please， 那个 bear cute， 我相信你 cute please， 等一下我眼睛破。Thank you very much all of you。
really enjoy the past 7 lessons, especially people who follow me from the first lesson to all the way to this lesson. I really appreciate it. As a goodwill, of course, the year-end party on the 29th of December, you're all welcome to enjoy the party. You will see all my students from different parts of Singapore coming here. Last year, we had one. This year, we're going to have a good one. And now you understand why I have every Saturday, we call it the Leadership Study Club, where this is where a place, a 空间 for you to present, showcase, talk to people, show anything to build out the confidence and de-stress. Okay? Thank you very much, Shixian. 祝你到新加坡 平平安安, 一路顺风, and good health. And all of you, thank you very much for coming. Those of the three of you who have not taken my exam, please arrange with me and get my contact number. I know Changgen don't have, so whoever have Changgen's number, please let me know. Okay, contact me, arrange with me. So next week, please do not disturb me. Next week, I will be away for holiday from 19th all the way to 23rd. But if you want to see me, please come to Khatib MRT station. There's a park there, you know, right, Nigel? Near the home team. Uncle Raymond is organizing a Christmas party to all my residents there. Okay?